Temperatures here in Greensboro right at 51, Winston-Salem the same. Mid-40s in Lexington, upper 40s in Asheboro and Burlington, as well as Martinsville, mid-40s in North Wilkesboro, 52 in Mount Airy. Your wake-up call is 53 in Danville. A few scattered clouds, especially over the Virginia counties, but they're mainly high-level clouds, not a lot of significant activity associated with them. Today we'll have another summer-feeling day. Those high-level clouds will mix out, but they'll make for a really nice sunrise this morning. With the purples and the oranges and the reds on fire and the full vibrant display there. And then they'll mix out and give way to golden sun this afternoon. That'll give our temperatures a boost today. Morning numbers quickly getting up into the 60s and by noontime up to about 74. And what's going to be a warm 80 degree temperature experience today. Yesterday we hit 78, so a pretty good practice run for what we have today. Notice the mild 70s even this evening. As you venture out to maybe get your kid at some of those ball practices or get some yard work done, getting those leaves that continue to fall more and more. You can see Sandy. Tropical storm Sandy, a strong big satellite signature here. Here's Jamaica, okay, this little island you see just to the north, and that's directly where this center is moving. It looks like it'll pass to the eastern part of the island, but winds have made it up to 70 miles per hour, movement to the north at 14. And yes, we can get tropical systems like this even this late in the year, even extending into November we can have these. And what's interesting is the computer model tracks taking this over Cuba, then the Bahamas, and then getting close enough to maybe bring tropical storm force winds maybe to Florida. And then the track gets important as we go into the weekend, because most of the computer models trying to take a turn to the right, some of them keeping it close enough to the coast. This is the center of the storm. I'll have you here. So again, don't focus necessarily on that. This is close enough to affect our coast in the form of rain and also in the form of sea swells. And then next week, we could see this baby take a turn to the north and back to the west, making potential landfall over New England, maybe somewhere like New York City, perhaps, or maybe Long Island or Massachusetts, maybe even further south than that. So hold your horses here. That's why we've been saying pace yourselves here, folks. This one has a lot of potential to it next week, and we have the potential to get very cold weather wrapping our way on the western side of this. You see a front coming in from the west over the weekend, and then look at the rain shield from Sandy, close enough to affect the coast via this computer model, maybe during the day Saturday. But you can see that center remains out over the ocean, but this is a large system, so it could indeed, in fact, impact our coast. Some of that rain may be drifting in really close to the Piedmont. That's why the 7 day does factor in some shower chances, especially Sunday. But look how temperatures really start to tumble. Sunday's highs only in the lower 60s. Monday's highs only in the lower 50s.